coming up from the Northeast Live Studios in Guwahati. Northeast Tonight with Wasbir Hussain.
Hello and welcome to Northeast Tonight, the show that decodes the region. As always, parties and political leaders have started addressing women directly during campaign for the ensuing assembly elections in Assam. The opposition Congress, desperate to put up a tough fight against the BJP, said if voted to power, the party would provide Rs 2000 per month to homemakers in the state who run their own households. In fact, this is among the five guarantees announced by Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi during her campaign tour of Assam earlier this week. In fact, the Congress has also said today, that they would provide 50% reservation of jobs to women in Assam if voted to power. The ruling BJP on its part has launched a number of schemes targeting women in Assam. For example, with an aim to encourage rural women, the Sonowal government distributed scooties among 4,238 women under Jivika Sakhi Express Scheme, Vistorito Konoklota Mohila Hobolikaran Yojana will pay a capital subsidy of Rs 50,000 each and revolving fund of Rs 25,000 each to self-help groups. This scheme is for empowering women. Girls securing first division in the higher secondary final examinations get a free scooty from the government. To promote education of the girl child, every school-going girl student will get Rs 100 per day for attending classes. And Indira Miri Harbhajanin Biddho Pension provides monthly pension to 1,43,318 women. In fact, these are the schemes announced and already in operation by the BJP government in Assam. Such programs are not surprising because women voters can currently determine the fate of candidates as they comprise as much as 49.3% of the total electorate for the coming polls in Assam. Of the 2.29 crore voters, women comprise 1.13 crore, that is 49.3%. According to a new National Family Health Survey, there are 1,012 female per 1,000 male in Assam. This is a key piece of statistics, viewers. Several questions arise. Parties are either giving sops or promising sops, but are they prepared to uplift women by giving them party tickets to contest the elections and become part of the decision-making process? How important are women's issues to political parties these elections? Are women themselves ready to contest and actually battle it out these polls? To discuss the issue, I am joined by Assam BJP spokesperson Janki Goswami. Congress spokesperson Dr. Juri Sharma Bodloi is also going to be with me. Also joining me is AGP leader and popular singer Kalpana Patwari. Actor and commentator Dr. Akaki Tora is also with me. And from Guwahati University, I am joined by Dr. Akhil Ranjan Datta, professor and a leading political analyst. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Northeast Tonight. First, I would like to start with you, Dr. Akaki Tora. You know, women's issues, the political parties and political leaders who are now already started their campaign are directly addressing issues. Now, before I ask you the question, let us listen to some of the voices of what the political leaders have been saying or promising the women of Assam. Let's start listening to what the political leaders have said one by one.
जो मेरी बहनें घर संभालती हैं, अपनी मेहनत से अपने पूरे परिवार की परवरिश करते हैं, बच्चों की परवरिश करते हैं और सबका देखभाल करती हैं, जिनको आज तक पूरी तरह से सम्मान नहीं मिला, उन बहनों को 2000 रुपए हर महीने गृहिणी सम्मान के तौर पर मिलेगा।
Please do take this message to the women of Assam that there will be a 50% reservation in all jobs for women, because If you look at the census of this, for the state of Assam, the population of women or the voters of women are almost 49% plus. And no society, no state and no country can progress unless 50% of the population is given equal opportunity to thrive.
হায়ার সেকেন্ডারিত পাঁচ ডিভিজন পোৱা ছোৱালী সমূহলৈকে আমি স্কুটির কথা কৈছিলোঁ, আমাক সদনত বহুতে হাঁহিছিলেও, এতিয়া 23,245 গৰাকী ছাত্ৰীয়ে স্কুটি পাইছে আৰু 18, 19, আৰু 19-20 ছাত্ৰীসকলকো স্কুটি প্ৰদান কৰাৰ কাম 17 তাৰিখৰ পৰা আমি আনুষ্ঠানিকভাৱে আৰম্ভ কৰিম, অৰ্থাৎ 15,000 আৰু অতিৰিক্ত হিতাধিকাৰী ইয়াত সন্নিৱিষ্ট হ'ব।
আমি যি ধৰণে বাজেটত প্ৰতিশ্ৰুতি দিছিলোঁ সেই ধৰণে আমি স্কুটি হাতত তুলি দিলোঁ, আৰু যদি 2021 চনৰ আমি 22,000ক ধৰোঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে আজি পৰ্যন্ত 37,000 ছোৱালীয়ে স্কুটি লাভ কৰে।
এতিয়া আৰু অসমে পাছলৈ চাব নালাগে, অসমৰ প্ৰত্যেকগৰাকী মহিলাই যেতিয়া উপাৰ্জনক্ষম হ'ব, কাৰণ মহিলা আয়ে এটা পৰিয়াল পৰিচালনা কৰাৰ ক্ষেত্ৰত আটাইতকৈ সিংহভাগৰ দায়িত্ব পালন কৰে। আমি সকলোৱে এগৰাকী মাতৃ সন্তান, সেইকাৰণে এই কথাটো আমি সকলোৱে উপলব্ধি কৰিব লাগিব। গতিকে মই আজি এইখন সভাত উপস্থিত থাকি অত্যন্ত আনন্দিত যে মহিলা আইসকলে ইমান ভাল কাম কৰিবলৈ সক্ষম হৈছে, সেইবাবে অসম চৰকাৰৰ তৰফৰ পৰা আকৌ আমি তেখেতসকলক অধিক উৎসাহিত কৰিবৰ বাবে আমি এইবাৰ 88,000 মহিলা আত্মসহায়ক গোটক এককালীন 50,000 টকাকৈ আমি আৰ্থিক সহযোগিতা আগবঢ়াইছোঁ। আৰু
অল ৰাইট ডক্টৰ আশা কিতাৰা, ইউ নো ইউ হেভ হাৰ্ড ফ্ৰম প্ৰিয়ংকা গান্ধী টু সুস্মিতা দেৱ টু ডক্টৰ হিমন্ত বিশ্ব শৰ্মা টু মিষ্টাৰ সৰ্বানন্দ সোণোৱাল, এভৰিবডি ডাইৰেক্টলি এড্ৰেছিং ৱিমেন, ৱেল দ্য বিজেপি হেজ ছেড ডাইৰেক্টলি দে হেভ অলৰেডি গিভেন স্কুটিজ, দে হেভ টকড এবাউট আদাৰ স্কিমছ ফৰ ৱিমেন, ইউ হেভ ছেড দ্য ইউ হেভ ছিন দ্য কংগ্ৰেছ প্ৰমিজিং 2,000 ৰুপিজ টু হোম মেকাৰ্ছ ইফ দে গেট ইলেক্টেড, এণ্ড দে আৰ সুস্মিতা দেৱ টুডে ছেইং দেট অ'কে 50% জবছ উইল বি ৰিজাৰ্ভ ফৰ ৱিমেন ইফ দে আৰ ভোটেড টু পাৱাৰ বিকজ ৱিমেন কম্প্ৰাইজ অলমষ্ট 50% অফ দ্য টোটেল ভোটাৰ্ছ অৰ ফৰ দেট মেটাৰ দ্য টোটেল পপুলেশ্যন ইন দ্য ষ্টেট। হাউ ডু ইউ টেক দিজ প্ৰমিজেছ, ডু ইউ টেক দেম ছিৰিয়াছলি, আৰ ইউ স্কেপ্টিকেল, আৰ ইউ হেপি, হোৱাট ডু ইউ থিংক?
লুক, the election centric battle is on right now. There is a difference between tall talk and walking the talk, as we know. Number one is that the ifs and buts are very hazy in political scenario, and we all know that politics is no child's play. The question come here is that change doesn't come overnight. Suddenly you see the surcharge of charging of all the political leaders, giving promises, talking about promises, giving scooties to girls, and so many flashy things are happening all around. But a question, perennial question, is that does it determine the real fate of women representatives? The key questions are here: does it really reflect all the aspirations of women? Do all of them, as they that in their manifestos, what they elaborate, what they issue based in manifestos, do they really highlight the women issues? There are many questions comes in the forefront.
Okay. Okay. We will continue. We'll elaborate on this. I have Kalpana Patwari with me, leader of the Aham Gana Parikhad. She'll be joining. We'll get her visuals soon, but she's at this point in time on the phone line. Kalpana Patwari, welcome to Northeast Tonight. The BJP has already given scooters. The BJP has already given a Briddho pension to women. BJP has already given 50,000 rupees as capital subsidy and 25,000 etc. revolving fund to self-help groups. The Congress is promising 2,000 rupees to homemakers if they are elected. The Congress is also promising 50% reservation for jobs if they are elected to women. Kalpana Patwari, what is your party going to give? What is your party stand on women? Do you believe in these kind of promises, or do you believe in something more?
First of all, let me express that I am more comfortable, like my political views I'll express it in Hindi.
Please speak in Hindi. It's all right. Mine is a bilingual, almost a bilingual show.
दरअसल देखिए मेरा जहाँ तक परिचय की बात है, मैं भी उन वोटर्स में से ही हूँ. एक साधारण महिला हूँ, एक गायिका नहीं हूँ, एक कलाकार हूँ. तो मैं एक्चुअली उस पक्ष में नहीं हूँ जो समझा जा रहा है कि राजनीतिविद या नेत्री वो हूँ, लेकिन सांस्कृतिक नेत्री, लेकिन साथ ही मैं गृहिणी हूँ. तो मैं अपने आप को जनता से अलग नहीं समझ रही हूँ. जो भी तो मैं बात करूंगी जनता से अलग नहीं हूँ, तो मैं जनता के पक्ष से बात करूंगी. मैं समझती हूँ कि कौन क्या देने जा रहे हैं, क्या बातें नहीं, वो सब इसमें हर पॉलिटिकल पार्टी एक्चुअली मेरे हिसाब से एक ही जगह चलता है. मेरे लिए ये इम्पोर्टेंट है कि हाँ, मैंने मैं क्योंकि अभी भी सिक्किम और बहुत ही इंटीरियर गांव देहात क्षेत्र में है, और मुझे ये बात इतना जरूर लगा है कि जो इस सरकार में पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम की जो फैब्रिक है, पॉलिटिकल फैब्रिक की एकदम माइक्रो लेवल में जाके, जिसके जो बूथ है, महिलाओं की जो बूथ है अलग अलग, उसके आशाकर्मी हो, उसमें अलग अलग कृषि जीविका, अलग अलग नाम से बूथ, बहुत सारे बूथ है. और महिलाएं सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है, महिलाओं को इस समाज व्यवस्था में और इस देश को इस निर्माण में महिलाओं को, वो भी गांव की बहुत सारे पढ़ी लिखी और बहुत सारे तो पढ़ी लिखी नहीं है, उन सबसे महिलाओं को इन्वॉल्व किया जा रहा है इस फैब्रिक में, इस पॉलिटिकल फैब्रिक में. आपको इस के जरिए आप भी समाज निर्माण कर रहे हो, आप भी देख रहे हो कि एक अगर रस्ते का कुछ आपको रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी देखा गया, वो इस बुद्ध तक डायरेक्ट फंड जा रहा है. और मुझे सबसे अच्छा लग रहा है कि एक जो होता है कि मैं महिला हूँ, मैं निर्णय नहीं ले सकती, मैं निर्णय तो नहीं ले सकती. वोट डाल के दिन मैं अपने अगर पति को पूछ के जाती हूँ कि किसको वोट देना है जी, ये जो बात है ये बिहार में भी मैं देख चुकी हूँ. और मुझे असम में ही अच्छा लग रहा है कि जहाँ महिला निर्णय ले रही है, उनमें आत्मविश्वास बढ़ रहा है कि मैं भी कुछ हूँ, मैं भी कोई हूँ.
एब्सोल्युटली, वेरी वेल सेड. आपने बहुत सही बोला कल्पना पटवारी जी. एक्चुअली 49.3% पॉपुलेशन, ऑलमोस्ट 50% आप किसी तरह से इग्नोर नहीं कर सकते हैं. आई विल कम बैक टू यू, मैं वापस आऊंगा आपके पास कल्पना पटवारी जी. लेट आई हैव गॉट टू पॉलिटिकल पैनलिस्ट, बोथ वुमेन लीडर्स ऑफ देयर रिस्पेक्टिव पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज. आई विल कम टू देम, बट बिफोर दैट डॉक्टर अखिल रंजन दत्ता, व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ दिस इलेक्शन 2021? यू हैव सीन both the BJP and the Congress, the two major political parties, directly addressing the women constituents. The Congress saying that 50% reservation for jobs they are going to give, they're going to give 2,000 rupees to homemakers. The BJP has already launched a series of schemes, right from, you know, giving scooties to women, girl childs, girl students, 200 rupees per day to those girls who attend classes and so on and so forth, including old age pension for women. So what do you make of this? Are they really serious about women's issues, or are they, can they ignore the women? Can women determine the fate of majority of the candidates in these elections?
Wasbir, I call it patriarchal patronage. You know, when you say that you have 50% of women, or for that matter, women voters or total population, and if you propose that 50% jobs will be reserved for women, that itself indicates that there is no guarantee that women will get equal share in an equal environment, in an equal footing, in an equally competitive environment. Therefore, I call it patriarchal patronage. You know, government has been, both Congress government, Congress-led government, and for that matter, BJP-led government, has been launching one scheme after the other for the women. But then when you look at political representation, the same government, look at BJP. You know, they had owned 60 seats in the last assembly election, 2016 election. How many women members were given seats for that matter? How many women members got elected to the assembly? Not a single women member were inducted into the, ministry, into the government, either by BJP or by SJP. only BPF, where they had three members in the ministry or in the government, one women member was there. Even if we look at, you know, if it is not merit-based, if it is merit-based, women are getting more and more opportunities. Look at the appointments, whether it is state appointment, whether it is appointment in the colleges, whether it is appointment in the universities. Because those are based on merit, women are getting more and more opportunities.
Okay.
Look at Guwahati University. In Guwahati University today, because admission is based on merit, 88% of the total population, total students are women. About 50% women are the teachers in the university. But when you look at the positions, whether it is vice chancellor, whether it is register, whether it is academic register, not a single woman.
Okay, you are talking about a broad trend, Dr. Kiranjan Datta.
Which is based on merit, they are doing it. Therefore, my understanding is that the kind of schemes being adopted by the government is very, very patriarchal in nature. They think that women are dependent on the government. They need the patroness of the government or the patriarchy.
Okay, I'll
therefore
come back to you. Okay, Ranjan Datta.
But it is not
I will
equality.
Come back to you.
It is not...
I'll come back to you. I'll come back to you. Two questions to you, Janaki Goswami, representing the BJP spokesperson of Assam. Janaki Goswami, you know, two things have taken place in the last 24 hours. One, the Congress, you know, is declaring today that 50% of jobs will be reserved for women in Assam if they're elected to power. And 2 days ago, Priyanka Gandhi saying that 2,000 rupees will be given to homemakers in Assam, those who have to lead their households, those who have to run their households. Your reaction?
I actually pity their thought process. Because if you see, it is just a battle of, you know, promises versus performance. When they are talking about where were they when there was rampant female feticide happening all across? Where were they when the gender bias was increasing day by day? Where were they when there were crimes taking place against women? Where were they when the women were getting economically weaker and weaker? And where were they when the dropouts of schools were increasing? They should have, had there been any aspiration for working for the woman folk, they would have taken steps long back. This country is, we are unfortunate to see that this country was having the highest rate of female feticide at one point of time. And that is so unfortunate to see. But now, because our government has rolled out schemes and programs and policies and campaigns which center about, around women.
I have a follow-up question.
Janaki Goswami. Janaki
Goswami. Janaki Goswami. It is the.
Why did they not have something else in their platter?
No,
why are they trying to follow the trend?
Listen
because
to me.
Because they have seen that we have. They are probably a little apprehensive.
Janaki Goswami, you know, it is a different another matter that it is the Congress party which has made this promise. But I'm asking you this question. Any political party making a promise of providing 50% reservation for women if they are voted to power, party X. What's your problem with that?
We have fulfilled.
What is your problem with that?
Any promise made by the Congress, we have no problems.
No,
if they want
I'm
to
not
fulfill it
Congress.
Before, if it, because
no,
if you see, even before the elections, even
no,
before
please
2019
listen to my question.
Election.
No,
yes.
My question was not that.
Yes.
My question, any party, party X, making a promise of giving 50% of the jobs to women if voted to power. What's wrong in that?
No, because if you see their manifesto, the concentration on women was not there earlier. The concentration on women has now taken a center place because they have seen that our government has rolled out policies and campaigns which center around women.
Point
if you
noted.
Talk about Beti Bachao, Beti Parhao, a big campaign which has taken place all across the country, which has started all across the country, as a result of this campaign, it is very, very heartening to see that the female feticide rate has come down in states like Rajasthan, in states like Punjab, in states
point
like Haryana.
Noted. Now,
we have the cylinder distribution, that is the Ujwala Yojana that was centered around women. A 9 crore people have been given free gas cylinders.
Right.
Why now,
Dr. Juri Sharma Bodoloi, what Janki Goswami of the BJP is basically saying, that your party has decided to focus on women in Assam this time for the 2021 election because you have been compelled to do so because of a series of measures that her party, that is the BJP, has drawn up specifically targeting women. That is her major allegation against the Congress. What is your response?
See, first of all, what Janki Goswami ji has said, I really feel really pity on the BJP party because they have not been a woman pro party. Because if you look at, they have been like, their leaders have been not giving importance to women as a whole. Because whatever she said, the fetishide of women fetishide, it has not reduced at all. And the crime against women has also increased. It's 7.3% rise in women crime against women. So if she is saying that, like, they are giving more importance on women empowerment or women, you know, for women, then I feel that security of women also has gone down because their life had been in threat. They are like, you know, if I take Assam, they are number one for the crimes of crimes against women. So I don't find BJP at all pro woman or pro female. So if you think about making policies, Ujjwala gas distribution of gas cylinder, but after that you are giving the rising the prices of the cylinder. What actually you want to say?
Let me complete.
And one more thing, like, women had not been given proper seat also in the assembly. If you talk about only jobs or other thing, making the like, women have a big role in the making the decision, policy making. If you don't give proper seats or proper representation of women in the assembly,
but
that also
but
is
you
a
cannot,
big issue.
You cannot it's take credit for that because let me tell out, in the last 2016 elections, only all the political parties combined together had fielded only 91 candidates, out of which only 8 women candidates won.
But I must say 2011 we had 11.1%, whereas BJP had only 6.3% of women candidates.
One thing I want to point out candidates here is that, first of all, I would like to tell Juri Sharma Bodoloi about one thing, that, see, crime against women, let us not forget the Nirbhaya case which took place in 2012. It's very unfortunate and I feel very sad to talk about it. But the thing is, it is not a question of blame game. We should not play around blame game when it comes to crime against women, because I think as women, we should be emphatic enough.
Dr. Akaki Tora, as someone who is a non-political person, as someone who looks at society very closely through your writings, through your acting, and so on and so forth, Dr. Akaki Tora, women's issues, do you think these issues need to be politicized? Any rape under any government is condemnable. We cannot accept it as a society. I don't care whether it is the Congress government is in power or the BJP is in power.
Now listen to a commoner.
It is unfortunate and we should condemn in one voice.
Listen to a commoner who's humble and who's very much into the fabric of society as a social activist, as someone who's deeply rooted, who's very concentrated on the women issues for last 3 decades. It's an irony that in 13 there are 14 women participated in the legislature, in the process of a political process. I'm talking about the participatory role of women in the process, in state legislature. And it has come down to only 8 women right now representing us. Assam do not have a single chief minister. From 1980 to 1982, it was Anwara Taimur as a woman chief minister.
That also was Congress.
I'm not talking in terms of political parties. And talking about crime rate, God, my God, crime rate's been increasing. Let's not talk about political parties. And women about, as you have already said, that there are women. Women and men, male ratio, voters ratio is almost similar nowadays. Yeah. 1,000 against 1,000 men nowadays, according to the report, health report. This is
1,012 females to 1,000 men.
So, the election manifestos or whatever the political parties are coming festooned with lot of promises. That's true.
Right.
But have you seen the price rises of the prices? Have you seen?
Hold on, Akhilatara.
I agree.
Let me. I'm coming to you, Akhil Ranjan Datta, in a minute. Miss Kalpana Patwari ji, you know, abhi hum log sarcha kar rahe hain ki you know. Issues, women's issues पर political parties क्यों अभी ध्यान दे रहे हैं? बीजेपी का कहना है कि बीजेपी ने इतना स्कीम्स लागू किया है महिलाओं के लिए, इसलिए कांग्रेस को they have been forced to come up with promises for the women. Now the issue, आप किस तरह से देखते हैं ये issue को? ये क्या political मामला है? But on one side अगर पूछता हूँ, ये अच्छी बात है कि political parties जो भी हो, they are at least women's issue को raise कर रहे हैं. मतलब इसका मतलब ये है कि they have been compelled to raise this issue. आप किस तरह से देखते हैं?
पहली बात तो जब मुझे ये कहा गया आज सुबह जब बात हुई कि आज महिला के विषय को लेके और खासकर महिला और राजनीति में महिला की निर्णायक भूमिका क्या है, मैं बहुत अट्रैक्ट इसलिए हुई, मुझे लगता है कि बहुत सारे महिलाएं इस वक्त इस पैनल में हैं और यहाँ ये बात नहीं है कि किस दल ने ये दल ज़्यादा अच्छा है महिलाओं के मामले में या किसको ज़्यादा सीट्स दिया गया. अलग अलग दल की बात हमें नहीं करना चाहिए. मैंने तो यही देखा है. मुझे लगता है जो स्त्री है, जो महिला है, वो अलग अलग क्षेत्र में होने के बावजूद महिला एक अलग ही कम्युनिटी है. मतलब यहाँ दल अलग होते हुए भी हम सभी महिलाओं को अलग अलग विचारधारा, अलग अलग दल में होने के बावजूद हमारा एक खुद का एक सोसाइटी होना चाहिए पॉलिटिकल, क्योंकि हम सभी एक ही जगह में है. दरअसल एक दूसरे पे ब्लेम गेम ये मकसद नहीं है मेरे लिए तो नहीं है. और मैं तो ये बात करना चाहूँगी कि इस बार जैसे गुवाहाटी में चार क्षेत्र है, समस्ती है, तो मैं तो देखना चाहूंगी कि ये चार में अगर तीन पुरुष है, एक में तो महिला होना चाहिए.
तो कल्पना पटेल जी, ये बताइए आप, यू आर ए पॉपुलर सिंगर, यू आर नोन इन नॉर्थ इंडिया, ऑल अक्रॉस द कंट्री. माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज सिंपल. मैं एक सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन है, आपने अगपा को ज्वाइन किया है रिसेंटली, तो आप डेफिनेटली आप इलेक्शन चुनाव कंटेस्ट करने का आपका इरादा है, तो आर यू कॉन्फिडेंट ऑफ गेटिंग ए टिकट? आज जब हम यहाँ बैठ के बात कर रहे हैं इस पैनल में, कल्पना पटवारी जी, दिल्ली में आपका वरिष्ठ नेतागण अभी मीटिंग में बैठे हुए हैं, टिकट एलोकेशन का इशू फाइनलाइज कर रहे हैं, तो आप क्या उम्मीद करते हैं कि आपको टिकट मिलेगा? अगर आपको टिकट मिलेगा, उसके लिए क्या आपको संघर्ष करना पड़ा था? किस तरह का संघर्ष?
हर महिला की एक्चुअली कहानी अलग भी है और एक जैसा भी है.
आपका खुद का कहानी क्या है? आपका खुद का पर्सनल कहानी क्या है?
मेरा पर्सनल कहानी तो यही है कि मैं अपने जिला में वापस आ चुकी हूँ. मैं बरपेता जिला में पैदा होती हूँ और बहुत संघर्ष करने के बाद आसाम पहुँचती हूँ. पढ़ाई लिखाई होता है, फिर बहुत सारा सपना लेके मुंबई पहुँचती हूँ. मुंबई में जाने के बाद उत्तर प्रदेश बिहार में मैं जाती हूँ, वो भी उत्तर प्रदेश बिहार में जहाँ औरतें दुपट्टा के नीचे होती है. पुरुष प्रधान समाज में मैं एक असम से जाती हुई महिला अपना झंडा जो गाड़ने की बात है, वो भी एक अलग ही संघर्ष है. भोजपुरी क्वीन या भोजपुरी सम्राज्ञी इतना
आप टिकट मिलेंगे? आपको टिकट दिया जाएगा कि नहीं? आपको टिकट के लिए उम्मीद करते हैं?
ऑफ कोर्स मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ. और मेरा कहानी मुझे खुद लिखना होगा. वुमेन इश्यूज में भाषण हम लोग बहुत देते हैं, लेकिन उसको सक्सेसफुली मैं एक समाज में अपने आप को इतना तो काबिल बनाऊ कि मुझे 10 लड़कियां मेरे पीछे आए.
Right. I will have to go for a break, but before that, Dr. Akhil Ranjan Datta, what do you make of this? There was a very interesting point raised by Janki Goswami. This is the Congress has, of course, refuted. Janki Goswami of the BJP has said that, you know, the Congress has been forced to come up with specific promises directed at women because the BJP in Assam has introduced a slew of measures directed at women, where the women are beneficiaries.
let me very quickly make two comments, then I'll address the question. When you talk about gender, I think it is not only men and women. I think this panel who are sitting here as representatives of different political parties also need to focus on the, that we need to go beyond the binary of men and women when we talk about the gender. The second question, Janki, I would like to remind you, if you look at the Sustainable Development Goals, and if you look at the parameter of health and well-being, Assam has performed worst. It has got in 2018-19, it has got 30 out of 100. It has scored 30 out of 100. And this is the worst performance. Now, when in health and well-being, the state is performing the worst, how do you say that women folk have benefited immensely in terms of nutrition, in terms of good health, in terms of access to so many other things that
so one needs are you to trying to say Okhilranjan Datta,
I don't think that these schemes
Are you trying to say that these are the issues which should be election issues rather than what the political parties are promising? Are you trying to suggest that?
Exactly.
I'll have to go for a break.
I say that patriarchal patron is giving scooty and giving gold will not really bring about qualitative transformation. Therefore,
what about 2,000 rupees? What about 2,000 rupees promised to homemakers made by Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi?
No, I think this will also go in the same line. This will also go in the same line. If you cannot, what do you get by this 2,000 rupees? Can it ensure good health? Can it ensure nutrition? Can it ensure
all right. Which I'll come back and I'll come back and carry forward this.
Therefore,
Okhilranjan
Datta,
I'll have to stop you.
Same line.
I'll have to stop you here. I'll have to go for a short break. Don't go away. We are in a very interesting discussion on the subject. I'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Juri Sharma Bordoloi, every political party fight elections to win. Your party has been in power in Assam for 15 years. Sure. In 2016, you were unseated by the BJP, which was waiting in the wings for long, trying consolidating itself over the years. Now, my question to you is, this time, there has been specific promises made by your party directed at women. And of course, women constitute 50%. But how, as a woman leader of a major political party, Dr. Juri Sharma Bordoloi, what do you think? Why is women representation so less in the political parties? What is your expectation? Your party, like the other parties, are also sitting today, engaged in the last couple of hours in trying to finalize the seats. You are also in an alliance with several parties. But women, who are the women? Are we going to see more representation this time? What do you think? Why are so less women in political
First,
parties?
Let me start with how women actually comes to politics. It's totally irrespective of parties, irrespective of beyond the party lines. Women always have to struggle too much to come into political arena because that's a public life. Women are always looked at as a homemakers, basically, in Assam. I'm talking about Assam and India as a whole. But then my point of view is not like in the political parties how we are giving promises to women or homemakers. Our stance should be how we have to bring women out from their homely things, and they should be one of the more decisive factor in the political system as well as in our policy making.
Mm-hmm.
So there it comes, like the legislative assembly, why we don't have proper representation of women? That should be a big question for all the parties. Number two, like giving promises. I won't take it that way. In the Congress manifesto, what Priyanka ji has said, actually, what is happening? We have to empower women. We have to give them direct benefits.
But Dr. Akhakitala, I have one more thing to add here.
That I come from Congress, so I have to tell you that in Congress, we have been giving proper emphasis on women empowerment. That's how, from Assam, I must speak about Assam. Assam has got the national woman, national Mahila Congress president from Assam, which is a big post and which...
I don't know whether one woman from Assam being made the Mahila Congress president...
So this is one of the ways of looking at it. Dr. Akhakitala, I'm giving you a specific question.
Hold your thoughts. I'm asking a specific question to Dr. Akhakitala. I'm coming to you, Kalpana Patwari. At the end of the day, politics is serious business. You have to win the election because every party, as I said, every party contests an election to win so that they can implement their policies and ideas. Now, why we are all blaming the political parties for not giving adequate women candidates. But now the point is, in the last elections in 2016, 91 candidates were given, but only 8 of them won the elections. That means vast majority of the 91 women candidates lost the elections. So why should political parties consider or do? Do you expect a women's quota? 33% reservation was there, but it has not come into effect. So what are your thoughts?
Look,
why will the political parties sacrifice seats?
Look, normally I believe in gender neutrality. I'm not a person who believe in gender bias things and all. But looking at the scenario, the question you asked me, there are two questions. Are women, largely, who are in politics, are at the mercy of those men folks? Again, the question of patriarchy comes. Number one.
Second question is, why do majority lose the elections? I'm repeating my question in a different way.
Why do most women lose? Look, there is a question of efficiency. How many efficient people we have been coming? The party is coming up with candidates. I'm talking about candidates, sir. How many efficient candidates are taken by or been nominated by the political party is a question. Largely women are, largely efficient, let me finish my sentence. Largely women are captivated by the fear of not taking plunge into the politics. And why this fear? Have you seen the latest trend of trolling? In social media, it's all about character assassination. It's all about taking women by names. The question is that efficiency is the benchmark
which Akhakitala. Let me go to Kalpana Patwari. Kalpana Patwari ji, aap pehle dafa aap active politics mein utre hain. My question is, aapka kya khayal hai winability? All the political parties are now saying that winability will be a factor. चुनाव जीतना पड़ेगा दैट इज वन ऑफ द क्राइटेरिया सिंपली बिकॉज समबडी इज अ मैन और अ वुमन वो बात नहीं है ईच इलेक्शन में बड़ा तगड़ा मुकाबला होने वाला है तो लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर सेइंग दैट विनेबिलिटी विल बी द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्राइटेरिया आपका क्या मानना है ये विनेबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया होना चाहिए या नहीं होना चाहिए
Of course होना चाहिए आखिर में आपको जीतना है आपको इस नज़र से इसको देखना होगा कि आपको 126 अगर सीट्स है तो आपको सरकार बनाने के लिए जितना सीट्स चाहिए तो वो लक्ष्य तो वही है तो विनेबिलिटी होना चाहिए जस्ट बिकॉज आप महिला है और महिला मतलब मुझे रिजर्वेशन चाहिए सिंपैथी ये नहीं हो लेकिन फिर भी एक बात तो है कि ऐसा भी नहीं है कि समाज में महिला मतलब काबिल नहीं है बहुत हद तक ये भी होता है कि पार्टीज के अंदर भी जो काबिल महिला है वो पहुँच नहीं पाती वहाँ तक तो ये मामला जो बात है ना ये बात सिलसिला ख़त्म ही नहीं होगा दरअसल जैसे मैंने कहा कि बरपेटा जो जिला है अगर यहाँ पर 8 क्षेत्र है 8 समस्ती है तो कम से कम यहाँ 3 तो महिला के चेहरा हम देखना चाहेंगे लेकिन उसमें ये बात भी आएगा कि वो 3 महिला जीत पाएंगे कि नहीं उनमें वो काबिलियत है कि नहीं तो मेरे हिसाब से ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट. फिर हम लोग बोलते हैं कि हम महिला और पुरुष बराबर है, तो मुझे इस मामले में क्वालिटी के मामले में मेरे जो प्रोफेशनल मेरा जो आउटपुट है उस मामले में मैं पुरुष और महिला हमको एक 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 कतार में होना होगा. दोनों बात बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट.
ओके जानकी गोस्वामी, डू यू एग्री विद दिस व्हाट कल्पना पटवारी हैज सेड दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम देयर आर मेनी ओकेजंस वेयर एक्चुअल एफिशिएंट वुमेन डू नॉट रीच दैट पोजीशन व्हेयरएज अदर वुमेन गेट द टिकट्स. डू यू एग्री विद दैट? दैट इज आल्सो नॉट ओनली
यस दैट इज ट्रू.
यू कैनॉट डिसमिस इट.
दैट इज ट्रू बिकॉज़ समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट इट इज नॉट ओनली द मेल्स डोमिनेटिंग द वुमेन, समटाइम्स द वुमेन देमसेल्व्स आर नॉट able to realize that they have the potential to deliver, they have the potential to prosper and perform. So that is the problem. Sometimes women themselves keep, I mean, they stop themselves from going forward. That is also a problem with the mindset. Maybe that has got something to do with the patriarchal, you know, inherent feeling that we have all around the social structure. That may have a big role in playing, you know, forming that opinion. But women themselves stop, you know, they stop themselves from going ahead. That is also one factor. And she has said one point which is very correct, and that is the efficiency, the ground level work that the candidate has done. You know, that also matters, because when it comes to giving a candidature, then what happens is every party is election centric. Every party's main goal is to win the elections. And for that, they approach with a very pragmatic, you know, they have a very pragmatic approach for that. So does the candidate, whether it is a male or a female, does the candidate fill into that criteria?
Right.
That also matters a lot.
Let me once again go to Dr. Akhilranjan Datta. Dr. Akhilranjan Datta, if you look at the Assam elections, all these years, I have been covering elections since 1985. That's been a long time. You have been also covering elections very, very closely. My question to you, Dr. Akhilranjan Datta, is very simple. When we talk about, Muslim votes, we talk about Tea Garden votes, these are block vote banks. You know, Muslim votes, okay, Congress has always enjoyed the Muslim vote. That was the, that quote unquote, that was what was the narrative for a long time. The Tea Garden votes, now the narrative was simple. Earlier it was a Congress bastion, now the BJP has made inroads. These are the common things which we get to hear. Now, do you think of late people are also talking about women votes? You know, these are women votes, 50% women votes in these elections, and they can make or break candidates. Akhilranjan Datta.
See, as I mentioned in the beginning, that the whole approach has been very patriarchal in nature. It's from the perspective of patroness.
Right.
When the political parties have been telling, either the Muslim booths, for that matter, Tea Garden booths, they have been telling that we'll provide you the patroness, therefore you give us the vote. They have not been telling that we'll treat you equally. This is your right, you get it. It's not that we are giving you. That is your right, right to life with dignity. That's a constitutionally given right. And we have been providing you the patroness in an environment where the resources have been appropriated by a very microscopic section of the society. Now, as far as women is concerned, I think that is also happening in that way. The government, all political parties have been telling, say, we are providing you this patroness, therefore give us the vote. But they have not been telling the women, see, you also constitute half of the population, therefore you have also the right to have half representation in the assembly or in the parliament. They have still been talking about 33% reservation for women. Now, the whole notion of reservation, therefore, I was telling, it is very, very derogatory. I mentioned, if you look at the competitive environment, look at the universities, you know, it is more than 50%, 60% women students who are there in the universities and colleges. And if you even go for appointment in a merit basis, women are doing better than the men. But when you go to the process of nomination, go to the process of selection, it still remains very, very patriarchal. Therefore, the whole approach of all political parties, it is not, I'm not talking about this political party or that political party, all political parties, the schemes that they have been adopting, those are being done keeping in mind the political mileage, electoral mileage, and they do it by keeping women, for that matter, Tea Garden laborers, for that matter, Muslims, dependent on the patriarchal political regimes, and therefore these are happening. But if you make it, for example, if you make all schools, both public schools, qualitative and competitive,
right.
All public hospitals,
okay.
Qualitative and competitive, and ensure safe drinking water, ensure free access to fuel, or for that matter, all necessities to manage,
yeah.
For the management of kitchen. This all patriarchal or all inequalities we can overcome. The political parties are not doing it.
Okay, Ranjan Datta, let me turn to you, Dr. Judy Sharma Badaloy. Do you think the political parties are really serious about women's issues? And do you think how important are women's issues to parties? Are the parties really willing to field women candidates? That is one of the key questions. And this time, because your voter strength is 49.3%, which is almost 50%, how can you not nominate people? How can you say that in today's day and age, I think nobody in this panel would disagree, including people from the BJP or Congress, that there are capable women amongst us even today. That nobody can say, capable, efficient women are not there. Nobody can say that.
Exactly. I really agree with you, Vasbiji. Irrespective of party, women have to be given proper platform, and they deserve it, because there are a lot of women who are really efficient, who can really give proper performance in the governance also, and they have proved it long time back. So even if I have to name, I name Indiraji. She has really proved her efficiency all over the world, like all over the, internationally. In the international arena, she has proved herself, her efficiency. Just like her, there had been a lot of, irrespective of party, I must name.
Problem lies with the parties. The problem lies with the thought process.
Maybe
it is a combination of both.
Combination of
maybe
both,
maybe women should also realize their own potential and come forward. Maybe women should realize their own potential and come forward.
In this issue, I must say.
Choose politics as a career option. They also need to choose
there are
career.
Lot of, see,
politics
Rajiv
as a career
has
option.
50% reservation for Panchayati Raj. There was a platform which was given to the women. Like there has to be 50% representation of in decision making.
So
because Panchayati Raj is the grassroots level, micro level, election process.
When meaningful
women
participation.
Are given, see,
meaningful participation of women in leadership role is always coveted.
You have to give a proper platform.
Right.
50%
no,
of
you
seats.
Want
yes.
Giving a
Panchayati
what I
give women empowerment.
Dr. Akhakitara, what are you trying to say?
Look. I mean to say that right from independence, what I mean to say, there are 29 leaders. If you see the international scenario, there are 29 leaders in the world. Those are the countries who even fight for, who even fought for voters' rights. We India have something in plata, but the irony is that the efficiency, our efficiency of a woman as a voter, efficiency of a vote of a woman as a major participatory role in politics are
right.
Concealed by reluctance. Number one, concealed by reluctance. Efficient women are reluctant to join in the mainstream. There are reasons for that.
We have already spoken about one point.
I mean to say that women are themselves not aware of their potential.
Exactly. That is the point I have been saying. That is the point I have been saying.
Not potential.
Let me complete my sentence. They are yet to be aware of
their own.
I want to tell you, as voter, as leader, we need another flash of revolution to make themselves aware that we are.
How a woman participates in the electoral process? In two ways, by voting, and the other is by taking part in the electoral foray. Okay.
Right.
Now, women are already playing a very important role in terms of voting, because if you see last Bihar elections, the percentage of women turnout was more than male turnout. So if we see that, we have a feeling that consciousness in women is increasing year on year. So
absolutely.
If they can be smart voters, they can also be smart leaders.
I agree with Janki.
Let me ask
if they can be smart voters, they can also be smart leaders.
Kalpana
that is my belief.
Aapko kya lagta hai ki political parties or netagan jo hai, they address issues to women because women जो है, महिलाओं जो है वो ज्यादातर इमोशनल होते हैं, तो when you address them and you know it is easy to swing their votes. आपको क्या ऐसा लगता है? Because you know अब serious है या serious नहीं है वो अलग बात है, लेकिन जहां भी जाओ चुनाव का एड्रेस करो तो वुमेन इशू एक रेज कर दो, महिला को टारगेट करते हुए एक अच्छा बात बोल दो, एक प्रॉमिस कर दो, सो दैट यू नो वुमेन आर जनरली इमोशनल एंड इट कनेक्ट्स, तो ज्यादा वोट मिलने का संभावना है, होता है. तो डू यू एग्री विद दिस काइंड ऑफ थॉट प्रोसेस?
नहीं नहीं, हाँ, लेकिन ये हर जगह है, ऐसा नहीं है कि वुमेन के साथ ही है. जब मैं यहाँ पे हूँ, यहाँ माइनॉरिटी प्रधान जगह है, तो यहाँ हर क्षेत्र का समस्या अलग होगी, प्रॉब्लम्स उसको कैसे हम हैंडल करेंगे, किस तरह से वोटर्स को ज़्यादा अट्रैक्ट करेंगे, हर क्षेत्र का अलग है हिसाब वो. और यहाँ अगर माइनॉरिटी ज़्यादा है तो यहाँ प्रॉब्लम ये है कि डी वोटर्स का यहाँ पे ज़्यादा सुनाई देगा, इसको निरापत्ता, मतलब आपको सिक्योरिटी दिया जाएगा कि नहीं, NRC, ये सब तो हर क्षेत्र में वो अलग है. अगर महिलाओं को अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए ऑफकोर्स वो किया जाएगा, लेकिन वो बात ये है कि आज जो हम लोग डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, पॉइंट है कि हम सवालों में ही घेरे रहेंगे कि इसका एक निष्कर्ष निकलेगा, मतलब प्रॉब्लम्स को ही हम डिस्कस कब तक करेंगे?
क्या करना चाहिए? 20 seconds. क्या करना चाहिए?
जो करना चाहिए, जिनको करना चाहिए वो लोग शायद अच्छा से नहीं कर पा रहे, तो हम कलाकारों को छोड़ के आना पड़ रहा है, तो हम भी देखना चाहते हैं हम क्या कर सकते हैं.
ओके, वुमेन आल्सो हैव अ रिस्पांसिबिलिटी. फाइनल कमेंट्स फ्रॉम यू डॉक्टर अखिल रंजन दत्ता. वेयर आर वी हेडिंग? 50% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन, दे कैन मेक और ब्रेक द फेट ऑफ मेनी कैंडिडेट्स इन असम दिस टाइम.
I think the leaders in all, women leaders in all political parties should emphasize upon the fact that women shouldn't be treated only as a vote bank. Women should be given equal opportunity of political representation. Women should be given opportunities to take part equally in terms of decision-making process. Unless and until the women members in respective political parties cannot challenge patriarchy within the respective political parties, we are not moving towards equality for both men and women.
All right, a final comment, 20 seconds, Dr. Akakitora. Where are we heading?
I think we need another flash of revolution where we should demand the key role of women as a voter and major participatory role as a candidature. And for that, women should back women more than male counterparts. That's necessary. In every party, all the political parties, in core committees, in other committees, as a candidature, everywhere, women should flash as a major key role in leadership. And that's
absolutely,
that's a demand and that's a necessity. Need of an hour.
Absolutely. Women should support women more in this kind of a scenario to tilt the balance in their favor. Dr. Juri Sharma Bordoloi, final comments from
My final comment is, if I talk about our party, because I'm talking about Congress, I belong to Congress, our major, like the president, is a woman. So that shows how we have been actually.
But she belongs to a particular family.
Don't tell me that, because Janki ji, that's irrespective, but she's a woman and she has led the party.
She is a CEC chairperson,
because she will be taking the decision, giving the representation to women also. And always we have seen, Congress has always given a proper representation in the assembly seats, as well as in the panchayat, as well as in the local board.
Right.
That's where I have to emphasize that Congress always give proper representation.
Okay, we'll have to wait and watch how many
and
candidates
here in this, yes,
the,
yes,
the
this
Congress
term also,
is able
we
to
are very much optimistic
in the election.
Juri
Sharma Bordoloi is optimistic, but we'll have to wait and watch. We'll come to know in the next few days how many candidates the Congress has filled it, or for that matter, the other political party. Janki Goswami, final comments from you. 20 seconds to you.
Actually, time is very short for me to cover many things that I wanted to, because Okhilda also had a question for sustainable development goal, but
time.
Yeah, I cannot go to that. So in a gist, what I would like to say is that meaningful participation of women in national, community and local level is very important for a balanced policy making decision and to usher in a progressive gender equal atmosphere, and we should always remember that.
Okay, viewers, let me give you a piece of statistics before I conclude. There were 1,064 candidates in the fray in 2016. Total of 1,064 candidates contested the Assam elections, of which women candidates were only 91, which is absolutely not even 10%. And then out of 91, only 8 women candidates won, managed to win the elections. So that reflects the women in actually in real decision-making power in Assam today. And we have to wait and watch as to how the political parties behave as far as this election is concerned, whether they nominate women in the first place, because winning or losing the election will come only later. First priority is for the political parties to nominate women. At the end of the day, we cannot forget that the parliament, we were actually pushing for 33% reservation, and some people are already in favor of this, some people are silent, some people are opposed, but we have to wait and watch. At the end of the day, we cannot ignore 50% of the population as far as the Assam elections are concerned. And let me tell you, viewers, that women will definitely be in a position to make or break the fate of not only candidates but political parties in this election. So, viewers, we already know the power of women as far as the Assam elections 2021 is concerned. I thank all my panelists for participating in the program and the viewers for watching the show. Good night and goodbye.